أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي واجعل لي وزيرا من أهلي اللهم فقهنا في الدين رب زدني علما اللهم إني أسألك علما نافعا رزقا طيبا وعملا متقبلا اللهم ألهمنا رشدا وعيسنا من شرور أنفسنا اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه اللهم أرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه آمين ثم آمين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. What would Allah do with your punishment? That is, why must Allah be concerned to punish you? What would Allah do with your punishment if you are grateful and you believe and Allah is ever appreciative and knowing? So here in this verse, Allah, who himself is mentioning his attributes as Shakirun Alima, who knows and who is appreciative. He is appreciative and he acknowledges. So he who acknowledges is mentioning and is ordering his believers and his bondsmen to be appreciative and to acknowledge the bounties and blessings of Allah. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about gratitude and ordering us all to be thankful and to be grateful to Allah. How grateful we need to be to Allah. Surah An'am verse 18 and Surah Ibrahim verse 34 are almost the similar words where Allah says, وَآتَاكُم مِّن كُلِّ مَا سَأَلْتُمُوهُ وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَظَلُومٌ كَفَّارٌ. He, Allah, gives you something out of what you may be asking of Him. Should you try to count your blessings, you would not be able to compute them. And surely man is more persistently wrongdoing and stubborn. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is here making us all realize His bounties and His blessings, and in return is asking us all to be thankful, to be grateful to Him. Allah's bounties and His blessings on all of us are so many, so numerous, innumerable, countless, endless. He has blessed us all with much more than our basic needs and requirements. He has blessed us all with what we know and what we even don't know. We are blessed with things we are aware of, and we are blessed with things we are not even aware of. We are blessed with what is in our knowledge, and we are blessed with what is not in our knowledge. We have been given what we asked for, and we even have been given what we did not even ask for. And you know, remember this, that the greater are the blessings and bounties which we have been and we are receiving, which we don't even ask for. And greater are the blessings and the bounties which we don't even know about and we are not even aware about. That is why He orders us to be grateful and to do shukr. As in verse 152 of Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders, فَاسْكُرُونِي أَسْكُرْكُمْ وَاشْكُرُونِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونِي. Remember me, I shall remember you. Allah orders And then he promises, remember me, keep in a state of remembrance of Allah, and then Allah will remember you. We have talked in detail about all of this. And now here in this verse, Allah says, how should you remember me? Not by counting things which I have deprived you of or which you don't have, but remember me by being grateful of my bounties, by being thankful of my blessings, of feeling obliged for all what I have given you. Washkuruli, be grateful to me and do not deny me. So here is a do of Quran, and that is what? To be grateful. It is an order of Quran, and it is obligatory hence for all of us to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then here is a don't of Quran. The don't is not to be ungrateful. Now, how can we be grateful to Allah? How can we be grateful to Allah, our sustainer, our creator, our benefactor? I would relate to our normal day-to-day life. How are we grateful and thankful to a person who gives us a gift or who brings a present for any one of us? You know, what we do is that first of all, we thank by the word of mouth. And then we start feeling obliged in our heart also. The love for that person becomes more. It magnifies. Our bond with that person develops. It becomes better. It becomes beautiful just because of that small little token of love that person has brought for us. And then the third thing is we try to talk about the gift the person has brought for us. And the fourth thing is we try to repay or return the gift. So how are we going to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, number one, we should thank Allah by the word of our mouth. By the words is Alhamdulillah. This is verbally thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whenever we receive a blessing, or whenever we remember a blessing, or whenever we realize about a bounty of Allah, we need to say what? Alhamdulillah. This is the verbal gratitude to Allah's blessings and bounties. The second is that we should be obliged, we should feel indebted to Allah and start considering Him and taking Him as our benefactor. And considering Him as our benefactor, we should try to obey Him even more than we used to previously. We should try to seek His pleasure even more than we used to previously. And then the other thing is that a method or a means of gratitude to the blessings is to use the blessings of Allah according to His commandments, according to His orders, and according to His limits, and the way He orders us to use those bounties. This is the way. This is the way we all need to be grateful and to be in a state of gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So because of this, gratitude is hence a very comprehensive worship. It is a state of a very comprehensive worship. And it definitely has physical, monetary, and spiritual components of worship all in it. Now, why does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala order us to be grateful? He doesn't need our being thankful, and it doesn't just matter to Him. He's not bothered about our being grateful, and it's not going to be of any importance. He won't value it. He is ordering us to be grateful for our own selves, for our own selves. So what are the advantages of being grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah clearly announces, وَإِسْتَعَزَّ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. Remember when your sustainer created you and he ordered that if you are grateful to me, I shall most certainly give you more. And if you are ungrateful, then remember my punishment will be severe. So twofold, Allah is promising and ordering here that if a bondsman is going to receive the blessings of Allah and going to receive the bounties of Allah, and then he is grateful and he acknowledges and he remembers and he mentions the blessings, then Allah will be so pleased with him. Allah will be so pleased with him that out of the prayer of the gratitude of the bondsman, Allah blesses them with even more bounties. And on the contrary, if the person is ungrateful, despite of being blessed, is ungrateful, just doesn't remember, just doesn't mention, just doesn't acknowledge the bounties of Allah, then Allah will punish him severely and intensely. And what this punishment is, you know, this is actually a fact. And it actually happens so, that the person is punished in this world because of his thankless state of mind and his thankless state of affairs. He is actually punished in this world. How does this all go about? That when a person is grateful, you know, then his sanity operates and he stays sane and he can see, he can count, he can feel and he can remember his blessings. And so in this state, he remains content, he remains happy. But an ungrateful person gets insane. And he just cannot remember, he just cannot think, he just cannot see, he just cannot feel and count the blessings of Allah. And that is why he gets upset and he gets anxious and he's disturbed, he's unhappy in his life, despite being blessed. So gratitude is a bliss. It is one of the best riches. It is one of the choicest wealths a person can have. A heart that is grateful. A soul that is grateful. And that is what Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to supplicate after the prayers. Rabbi a'inni ala zikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadatik. O Allah, help me that I keep remembrance and help me that I be grateful to you. So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to pray for being grateful and used to pray for remembrance of Allah. And the companions of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam asked him that what do we need to keep astray? What do we need to gather? And he said, three things does a believer need to collect or gather or collect a treasure of. And what are these three things? A tongue which keeps on praising Allah, which keeps on mentioning and remembering Allah, and a heart and a soul which is grateful to Allah, and a body which is patient in the path of Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the luckiest person on the earth is one who has been blessed as four blessings of Allah. And these four blessings of Allah are what? A tongue which is always supple with the names of Allah, with the remembrance of Allah, with the praise of Allah. A heart which is always in a state of gratitude to Allah. And a body which is always patient for the obedience in the path of Allah, and a spouse who is a helper or who is a supporter for the obedience of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with all these four bounties. Bless us with all these four riches of the world. Because you know that, I repeat again, gratitude is a bliss. It is the best of all the riches, and it is the choicest of all the wealths or treasures we can keep or we can hold. Because you know that if there is a person who has thousands and thousands of blessings of Allah, who is a very blessed person of Allah, but he is deprived of a grateful soul, he is ungrateful, he is thankless, then always, despite of so many blessings, so many bounties and rewards of Allah, he will always be cribbing, grumbling, bickering, complaining, and hence he will always be upset and tense and disturbed and unhappy. But on the contrary, a person who is deprived, he is deprived. He might just be having a very few blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but the best blessing he has, that he is grateful and he has a heart which is thankful to Allah. Then remember, despite all his deprivations, he will be in a situation of hardships, he will be happy, he will be contented, he will be satisfied and relaxed. No upsetting and no tensions and no stresses and no nervous breakdowns. And this is what is useful for all of us. Allah will bless us more, and Allah will bless us with sakina and satisfaction and contentment of the soul. Verse 40 of Surah An-Naml, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala narrates the incidents of Hazrat Sulaiman radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and says that Hazrat Sulaiman radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when he saw that the throne of the queen of Saba had been brought immediately after his order by one of his slaves, then he exclaimed and he said, Haza min fazli Rabbi. Haza min fazli Rabbi. This is because of the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that it was brought to me. It was because of the bounties of my sustainer. So, receiving a bounty and a blessing of Allah, he was not proud. He did not get vain. He was not arrogant. He humbled and he was grateful to Allah. Haza min fadli Rabbi. And then he said, why has Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed me with this? Liyabluwani. So that he tests me with this. He puts me into trial with this. So remember, the bounties and blessings of Allah are actually a trial for the bondsman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to see that when I bless him with something, is he grateful to me or is he ungrateful? And then Hazrat Sulaiman said, Liyabluwani. And how does he, Allah wants to try me? Ashkuru am akfuru. That whether I am grateful or I am ungrateful. Ashkuru am akfuru. And then he said, Waman shakara fa innama shakara li nafsi. Waman kafara fa inna rabbi anni kareem. وَمَنْ كَفَرَ فَإِنَّ رَبِّي غَنِيٌ كَرِيمٌ. So he said that whoever will be grateful for his own good, and whoever is ungrateful, then verily my sustainer is self-sufficient and generous in giving. So Allah is self-sufficient. He doesn't need our gratitude. He doesn't need our appraisals and remembrance. He is self-sufficient. He is not bothered and he is not concerned of our prostitution and of our worships and of our praising him. and He is generous in giving. This gratitude and this state of being grateful is what is important for us. And who do we need to be grateful to? First of all, and the topmost, we need to be grateful to Allah. Because a person who cannot be grateful to Allah will obviously, very obviously, he will not be able to be grateful to the fellow beings. So the first order of preference in our being grateful and thankful is to be thankful to Allah. And then the next is to be grateful to our parents. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَنِشْكُرُوا لِي وَلِوَالِدَيْكَ وَإِلَيَّ الْمَصِيرِ. Be grateful to me and to your parents, and remember, to me shall you return. So Allah orders, after His gratitude, Allah orders gratitude of the parents. To be grateful to the parents, to acknowledge what they did for us, to acknowledge the way they loved, the way they cared, the way they were kind and merciful to us, to acknowledge what they spent on us. Because remember, all what we have, all what we are, wherever we have reached in our lives, whatever we have achieved and attained, is all because of the love, of the kindness, of the mercy, of the efforts, of the struggling of our parents. So we need to be grateful to our own parents, and obviously the parents of our spouses. And then a woman, after the gratitude of Allah, has been ordered to be grateful to her husband. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam narrated, the words have been narrated in Bukhari, that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that today I was shown and I witnessed the most dreadful scene of the hell. The most dreadful scene of the hell. And there I saw that women were in majority. The companions immediately asked, why was it so? And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, because they are always complaining and they are finding faults and they are ungrateful. Companions asked, are they ungrateful to Allah? He said, no, they are ungrateful to their husbands. And how it is, he explained that throughout her life she receives from her husband his love, his protection, his care, his guidance, his support, physical, emotional, monetary, social, all forms of things she receives from her husband. But the moment there is an issue, the moment he remembers, he forgets, and there is an issue, she immediately says that I have never ever received anything from you. So this is being thankless to the husband. This is being ungrateful to the husband. We have all been blessed by the bounties of Allah, but you know that we have in our lives so many lack of gratitude and the behaviors of being thankless to Allah, that you know that this is one thing which is consuming all the contentments. This being in a state of not being thankful to Allah is finishing off, and is in fact, I feel, burning off all the happinesses and consuming all the contentments of the individuals and of the families. Like, you realize that there's so many conditions in which people are not being grateful. A person may be having all the blessings and she may not just be having her own personal house, and she will be continuously complaining and crying and like being unhappy about it. I don't have my own house. Not thinking about the thousands of blessings other than, but continuously complaining about the lack of not having her own personal house. And then when she gets a house, the next complaint is, it's too small. And if the house is not small, it's big enough and it's large enough, then the next complaint is that the locality is not posh. We don't have our house in a good locality. Even if the locality is nice, then the next thing is the house, the finishings and the fittings in the house are not up to the mark. They are not latest. And if this is also fine, the next thing and the next complaint is that we don't have the latest and the best of the furnitures. We've not furnished our house properly. It's all old-fashioned and it's all old. Even if we have that, the next thing is we don't have any servants to look after and to help maintain the house. Continuous state of cribbing and grumbling and complaining and not being grateful of what we have. This is a norm in the society, you know. There's another lady who has to attend a party or has to go to a gathering. She starts complaining. I don't have any clothes. If she has clothes, they're all old. People seem to have seen them previously. If she has new pair of clothes, then the next complaint would be, they're not designers. If she has a good dress, a designer dress for her to wear on the occasion, the next complaint would be, I don't have a matching handbag and I don't have a matching shoe. And she has a matching shoe or handbag, the next problem will be, I don't have a designer handbag and a shoe. If she even has that, the next complaint would be, I don't have matching jewelry. So there you are. This is being totally ungrateful, never contented, never happy. Then there may be a girl. She is just married and she is running a separate family. She has a separate house. And she is always complaining. She's always talking to her friends and telling them, had it been for you to run a separate system, you would have understood how difficult it is and how difficult the state of affairs is for me. And then there is another one who is living in a combined supported system. And she very ungratefully is heard talking in her friends, just if you had to stay and if you had to stand being with your in-laws from morning till evening, all the day long, being with your mother-in-law, neither of the two are happy in the situation because they are both ungrateful. Children at the dining table complaining, being ungrateful, or what Allah has given them, or what the mom has prepared for them. Don't we very commonly come across all this? Excellent food prepared and served, but the children cribbing and grumbling. Why do we have to eat bread today? Why not rice? Okay, if rice, why not pasta today? If pasta, why not pizza today? If pizza, why was it homemade? Why couldn't we get a home delivery? Endless, endless, thankless comments. And you know what? Then the mom cribs. She gets upset with this ungrateful and thankless behavior of the children. She gets, I'm fed up. But the mom, little does she realize, from where did they learn this? From where did they learn this? They might have very well learned this behavior from the mom herself. The thankless mom, who was in the habit of cribbing, grumbling continuously to her husband, instead of being grateful to him for all he could and all he had arranged very lavishly, she was continuously gripping, she was continuously grumbling and finding faults. So this is what they had seen, this is what they had observed, and this is what was precedented. So now the mom needs not be upset about what they've learned from her herself. And remember, gratitude or being grateful has absolutely no relation with the person's blessings. It is just a frame of mind and it is a state of feelings. It is an outlook to life. In the same condition, a person will be grateful, and in the same condition, you will see that another person will be ungrateful. As the words go, when they say, two men behind the prison bars, one looked at the darkness and the other saw the stars. So this is an outlook to life. Fi amanillah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.